Three inchworm arms with push-ups. So reach down to the ground, stretch out those hamstrings a bit, lock your hands out into a push-up position. Do that push-up, lock your hands back up toward your feet. Do that three times, please. Side of our scorpion stretch. This one face down on the ground, kicking that leg over towards that opposite hand. Nice and easy. Spin back the other way. Five per side, total of 10. Each direction of our box jump. So we're hopping forward to side, back, side. That's once. I'll do that way 10 times, and then I'll go back the other way. Total of 20 jumps. Inchworms with another push-up. Each of those. Scorpion stretch. This time for the scorpion stretch, once you get there, and our face down, instead of having the arms up in that T position, try to bend the elbows about 90 degrees. As I come over, that'll give me a bit more of a stretch in the chest as well. So try 90 degrees with the elbows. Beatbox. One more round through. Done. Warm.
Yeah.
So, skill today, we got four different parts to it. It's going to be a rotating EMOM, so we got 1 minute to get through each station or each movement. First movement is going to be handstand push-ups. So, kind of way to modify that will be with my chair here. A couple ways you can either have your knees or your feet on it, depending more on your flexibility. For me, my hands are pretty tight, so I just like to kind of pop my knees on here and walk my hands kind of as close as I can. Put a lot of pressure onto my hands and come down. Head all the way down to the ground. I'm going to press up, try to drive my head back through my arms. Coming down, pressing back up. Again, I can do the same thing for my feet. That'll probably apply a bit more pressure, so a bit more weight to the arms. Then press back on up that way. So we'll aim to get eight in done in a minute. We'll rest. Next minute, we're going to go into our 12 cross-body planks. So I'm just going to pause for a brief moment. Each of them is on the opposite arm, opposite leg. Come back down, that's one. Opposite arm, two, three. I go for 12 total on those. Then, minute three, 16 chair dips. I'm just gonna lower down, drive back up. 16 of those. And then the last one will be a 24 second arch hold, which is all multiples of four. So I'm gonna be down on the ground, Superman hold, arch hold, whatever you wanna call it. Reach my arms up and my feet up at the same time. Hold that for 24 seconds.
So for those handstand push-ups, you want a lot of push-ups then?
You can if you want, yeah.
Okay, I'll try.
Yeah.
Eight's a lot.
Yeah.
So we're supposed to actually do the handstand, and then if we can't, we do the other one?
No, you can do the chair. The chair.
Okay.
I mean, if you can, like, kick it up,
do eight,
lower down, and then press back up. You can do it that way as well. Yeah, just pretty much trying to work on pressing back up. You can even do it without a chair. Just kind of this pike position, lower down, press back up as well, and then you can kind of adjust how much weight you have on your shoulders.
Okay, so it's the push-ups, then it's
the planks,
plank lift, 12 of those.
Yeah, 16 chair dips.
16?
16, yep. And then 24 second arch hold. I'll keep you guys on track.
Okay, and we got a minute to do that?
But yeah, a minute to do each one. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you do the handstand push. Yeah. Yeah. Handstand push-ups, then rest. And we'll get set up.
Oh.
Set up for your handstand push-ups. We're going for 8 reps. We'll go in 3, 2, 1, go. Once you've done 8, rest.
God damn it.
Drove my knee into the door handle.
Ooh, that's smart. That's not part of it.
No.
12 planks? Can we start it?
Nope, I'll let you know. I'll let you know when to go. We got 20 more seconds to rest. Got the timer going. 10 seconds, you get set up down on those cross body planks. Again, don't rush it, try to hold each of those positions for a good 1 full second. Find that stability before you move on. 3, 2, 1, go ahead. 12 total. Once you're done those, get rest again. Good, we got 10 seconds before we're going into our chair dips. So for these, you can, easier will be bending my knees in. I can use my feet to kind of press up as well, almost like a glute bridge. If I go straight legs, mostly just arms pressing up. All right, go ahead. 16 reps of those. I feel it pretty good in the front of the shoulders, back of the arms a bit as well. Once done though, let's get to rest.
A 24 super rep?
It'll be a 24 second hold, so I'll keep you on, I'll let you know when 24 seconds is up.
Okay.
Just hit. What's that?
With this one?
The line on your belly. The Superman or arch hold.
Yeah.
Just hold, okay. Hold in this position for 24 seconds.
And okay, you, okay, hold it for 24. Cool.
Hold it. We're up.
Hold,
yeah.
Hold it for 24 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and go. So actively try to reach those arms up and the heels up. Also trying to make yourself as long as possible. So you're kind of reaching those fingertips forward, reaching those toes and heels backwards, if that makes sense. 3, 2, 1, rest. All right, that is one round. We're gonna do 3 more rounds through. So our handstand pushup will be our next one. Make adjustments as needed on those. But you got 15 seconds to rest. All right, go ahead. Sorry. 8 handstand push-ups. Too, or maybe not really other options, but kind of ways to maybe make it a bit easier too if you're struggling a bit. Take a pillow or a yoga block or some kind of target. So as I'm coming down, I'm just reducing my range of motion, and then I can press back up that way. It's just something to keep in mind as you're going through on those. Same thing I can do if I want to progress to doing them on the wall. Kick up onto the wall there, lower down, and then you press back up. So that's gonna make it a lot easier, that last range of motion. Anyways, next one. Go ahead on those cross body planks, 12 reps of those. Yeah, so Rob, if you can, we're gonna go be on the toes. So I'm holding full plank.
The bridge.
Yeah, I didn't see that the first time.
Well, that's way harder.
Bit harder, yeah. Seconds, then we're gonna go on our chair dips. Another 16 reps of those. All right, go ahead. Chair dips, dresser dips, whatever you got on your desk. Yeah, no. And 15 seconds, we're going for our arch hold. Three, two, one, go ahead. 24 second hold. Squeeze the butt, try to keep the feet together. Halfway. Three, two, one, rest. Two rounds done.
That's harder than the second, third round.
Yeah. This might be as hard as the wad, who knows. I like to think this is easier because I feel like you're getting more rest, but
yeah.
In my head that makes it easier, but not always. All right, round three of our handstand push-ups. Three, two, one, go ahead. Try to get those hands, that head down in between the hands. Starting to feel in the arms a bit between those and the dips. I feel like that's a lot of arm action. Yeah. 10 seconds. Cross body planks. Three, two, one, go ahead. Work. 10 seconds. Got our chair dips. Three, two, one, go ahead. Plenty of rest time here. Fifteen more seconds. Go on our arch hold. One more round. Three, two, one, go ahead. Soaring through the sky. Like Superman or Aladdin. You can be Aladdin's carpet. Three, two, one, rest. One more round. And then we'll move on. Thank you. go ahead. Round number four, final round. 8 more handstand push-ups. Done with those. All right, 3, 2, 1, go ahead on those cross body planks. Rob, you're an expert at those by the end.
Oh, yeah.
Seconds, and then we're going for our final arc. That's the skill portion of the day. Hopefully you feel more skillful now for our WOD interval style workout. We got 3 different movements. It's kind of a pyramid. We got 1 movement, another movement, third movement, then we go back the way we came. Every 3 minutes for 5 sets, we're gonna start off with 10 hang, clean, and jerk. So any kind of object will work. If you have a dumbbell, that'll probably be kind of the gold standard, and I'll kind of demonstrate what that looks like. So I've got my plate, which is similar to dumbbell. So the hang position, I'm just gonna come down kind of either in between the legs or just out to the side. So I'm not going all the way down to the ground, just kind of hanging down on my body. Swing it up to my shoulder, and then I can press it up overhead. That's 1. If I'm using a single arm, I'm gonna switch each time. So I'm gonna go 10 total. If I have something that requires 2 hands to hold, I can do the same idea, coming down just in between my legs, up to the shoulder, press up, just kind of go to the other shoulder, press up, 10 total reps of whatever you got.
We can do 5 one side, then switch and do 5 the other if you're using dumbbells?
Sure.
Okay.
Sure, you can do that. And then after those 10 reps, we're gonna go into 20 skater jumps. So I'm loading up on one side, one leg, press off sideways, laterally, 20 hops this way, aim for a bit of distance. Don't need to kill yourself, but not just little dinky ones. So 20 skater hops or skater jumps, and then 10 star plank rotations. So this, holding that plank, then I'm gonna rotate up to the side, into my T, into my star. Come back down, rotate the other way, up into the star, just like we're doing with those cross body planks. Hold that position for just a moment to find that balance. We'll rotate 10 total, so it'll end up being 5 each direction of those. Back to the 20 skater jumps, 10 more hang, clean and jerks, then you rest. You got 3 minutes to get that done. Get to hopefully get it done in about two and a half minutes. You get some rest, and we're gonna repeat that for 5 total sets.
Okay.
Questions? We're good. So any kind of object you got, even if it's just a can of soup or something. Start my timer. Here we'll go in 3, 2, 1, action. So 10 clean and jerks. Yeah. And after 10 reps, onto those 20 skater hops, skater jumps. Use those glute muscles to load it up on the side. Drive off, take yourself on that single leg. Feel athletic as you're going through. Then we're into those 10 star plank rotations.
Star rotation.
So you're holding the plank, up to the T, add the leg, that's a star. Then rotate back the other way. And of those, back to those 20 skater jumps. 20 skater jumps, 10 more. Hang clean and jerks. Just about 2 minutes in. Clean and jerks, and then get a short break before we repeat it. All right, take a break. Once you're done, you've got about 30 seconds till we're repeating the whole thing. Not a lot of rest here. Rest, you can take it, or you can just adjust the reps down a bit. Maybe you're doing a few less skater jumps, whatever you need to do. But we're going 10 seconds, starting again. 3, 2, 1, and go. 10 more hand clean and jerks. Oh, peanut butter.
Double pack.
It's value because it's not only buying bulk, but you also get the workout with it. 15. That's where Tabitha. Just past the minute 30 in, so looks like we're going a bit quicker this round, which is nice. Get a bit more break. Get to rest. Oh, nice. More rest. Got about still 35 seconds. Harder or easier than the skill?
Harder. Well,
different.
Hard.
Yeah.
Don't take that. It'll be a bit harder on the side of the loop.
Okay. 10 seconds. Round 3 coming up in 3, 2, 1, and go. Doing 5 rounds total. This is the Wednesday round, the middle round. My glutes are sore just watching these star planks and the skater jumps. Woo! Doing good though, doing good. Nice team, getting even faster. 45 seconds to rest. The power through here, power through.
Still
breathing. Good, we got coming up on the 2 minutes. Plenty of time, get a bit more rest going to the final round. Start with the 2 minutes on the dot. 1 minute break. And the last round.
Maybe we're right from the gate.
In here?
Or just the coordination is getting harder.
That makes sense. Twenty seconds. Yeah, one last round through. Five, four, three, two, one, and go. Try to make this round your fastest round if you can. Fast transitions and nice work. Keep that balance on those star planks. Done. Under 2 minutes on that round. Woo! Nice, Rob.